probably all know that by now, because that's all they seem to use. And the reason I really enjoy working with found materials is the history that it brings to the work. So when I look at something like lino, I can imagine all the meals that have been cooked on this, all the beds that have been on this, all the family celebrations, the best room in the house. You know, there's always been a best room. I grew up in the 50s and in a house full of colourful linos. It's not just about that obvious history. There's lots of histories. And the reason why I've done something with the underside of the lino as well, so it's this lino and that's the underside of it. I'm talking about the hidden histories and the things that we don't talk about. In this particular work, I'm talking about my childhood memories. So they are all the colourful, happy Christmases and meals with relatives and all those happy things. And then I'm also talking about tragedy and the underside of the happy memories. There are other memories that coexist with the happy memories. I've sewn these. I've sewn them together in an attempt to mend, to stitch it all back together again. So the top one, you can imagine, that's my stitched life. That's how I see my life. It's really been a happy life. And then the lower one, I've stitched back together all the memories that are beneath the happy memories. And in the attempt to stitch it together and mend it. And I feel that that's what my art does. The whole process of art for me is working through processes and healing myself. So here we have the healed Helen. Okay. I don't know many people who stitch lino. My 32-year-old faff sewing machine has decided it doesn't like it anymore and it says, enough. I don't know what I'm going to do now. I've just been working on some more lino work, but I've had to glue it together. It's not quite the same as stitching.
What did you do by hand? By first pricking it, you know, with some sort of tool, making little holes and then...
I have in the past... Yes, made all the holes all the way around the edge and crocheted them all together. And it was incredibly laborious and I swore I would never do that again.
Ah, so you go for the easy solution.
Through the sewing machine. Yeah.
Yes. I was wondering how the sewing machine would have
I would love an industrial sewing machine. Most of the linos are fine. It's this yellow one. That yellow one, I think, has more bitumen in it. I only use the early linos, pre-1950. Post-1950, they have asbestos in it. So I only use the very early ones, and I think this one just has too much bitumen, and it breaks the thread, and it fills up the hole in the needle all the time. It's really annoying.
Is it quite flexible still? If it's that old, or do they break down?
It depends. This one's not flexible at all. This one's quite flexible still.
Yeah, okay.
You could also make little packages out of them.
Yes.
Put them together and then just tie them together.
That's a great
idea.
Make
the flexible ones, for example.
Even just bending it where it doesn't break, that would work.
Or just make one hole on top into a pile of them, you know, just bind them together on at one point. So
Thank you.
Or chains.
Yeah.
With two holes on each end.
Like books of wallpaper. But now it's lino. And they used to be big books of lino, just like that.
Like the carpet books, that you still get the carpet books.
Exactly, yeah.
So where did you gather these materials?
She went to abandoned house.
Generally, yes.
I have been known. Okay, this one and this one were in homes in Bunbury, and the new owners of the homes knew that I collected. I don't know those people, but they knew I collected lino, and so they get in touch with me and say, I'm doing my nana's house, do you want the lino? And so that was from a lady's nana's house, and I made her some houses and put the lino on the houses so she could have her lino back in care with her.
I love fake textile. You know, see how some of them have that pixelated nature, like they're faking a textile.
Absolutely. Yeah. Because the original linos way back were screen printed.
Yeah, you can see the screen printing, but this one here, for example, is like really pixelated. Like they're actually trying to replicate embroidery.
Yes.
That was a very disappointing lino. Oh, a friend in Fremantle said, I'm redoing the house, come and get the lino, right? And I left it for 2 weeks till the next time I was going to Fremantle. And when I got there, he said, oh no, I took it to the tip, but I saved you this bit.
Yeah.
So it was so beautiful, but this one, for instance, and that one. Josh and I were driving to Perth, and it was Carly's 30th birthday, daughter's birthday, and on the back seat, I have to paint the picture, on the back seats, not only our party clothes, but this very large cake, Persian love cake, covered in crystallised pink rose petals. And next to it were dozens of heart-shaped shortbreads, some with pink and some with white icing on them, right? Very precious food, all requested by the birthday girl. Driving down Old Bunbury Road, across the South West Highway, and we both looked at each other and said, that was lino! And there on the side of the road were three rolls of lino, that one and two rolls of that one. So we reorganized the food, because rolls of lino are like 2 meters long, right? And we propped them up over the seats, right? It kept driving to Rollystone. The smell was unbelievable. But that's how I got those linos. That lino used to be Linda Scully's and Russell Sheridan's bedroom lino. Yeah.
Helen, is there some metal on those
as
well? Yeah, I didn't just notice them today. I've looked at this piece probably quite a few times now, but I just noticed the camouflage.
In this piece, the family tragedy happened in the Pilbara.
Okay.
So this was an attempt to make a Pilbara landscape.
Oh, right. Oh. Yeah.
And hence the iron. Mm-hmm. And besides which, apart from lino, I love deteriorated metal.
Oh, it's gorgeous. Yeah.
Yes.
It's a beautiful piece.
Thank you.
Is Linda in the show as well? Why is that name so familiar to me?
Linda's in
the
other room.
Yeah. I thought the name was familiar, I just couldn't place what it was.
Yeah. Okay, it's important to me to have all these pieces of thread hanging as well. I think it's just a relief from the very vertical nature of this to actually have something, I guess, more spontaneous hanging down.
Also softens them, otherwise they can be quite sort of graphic forms.
Yeah.
Kind of makes it a little bit more sort of homemakey, sort of relatable yeah. or something, I suppose.
Yeah. I found that with the new work that I've done that's glued together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It becomes more architectural almost a little bit. It does remind me a little bit of. Do you remember how they used to do old maps? And each, say,
yes.
states in the US, they would paint Texas yellow and there'd be a cow on it. And then you end up with this whole, the whole US would be all different niche sort of patchworks of colours and illustrations and everything like
Fruit,
that.
Fruit, milk bottles.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Or like the old tea towels they used to do.
Almost like a quilt. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's got that.
Yeah.
But it's still got like, I can see little houses as well. You know. Like almost like a community with the little houses.
Because they're vertical?
Oh, yeah, I think, and the little bits. Yeah, just me.
Yeah. I love the whole thing of yes. stitching too, and just the whole idea of bringing things back together again.
Yeah.
Yeah. I, it's, there's something very deep and wholesome about it, you know what I mean? Mm. Like healing.
Yeah. That's how it is for me. Mm. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, I already can understand that. Yeah.
You could take it further, although I think I might keep this idea from No, I was thinking about if you took the patterns from all these various linos and printed them on fabric, and then out of the fabric you can make a quilt, which is something very comforting.
Yes. Right? Yeah.
So you have the memories and you can wrap yourself. Memories in bed, you know, to be comfortable.
Yeah, that's lovely.
Or you could get a lino produced from the lino.
I must say, I'm actually quite astounded. I didn't know anything like that. I know lino, but in this kind of pattern, that to me is wallpapers, you know, with flowers and so on. I never had the idea of something like that on the floor.
Yeah.
Quite weird to me.
Thank
like for me, I always, my first idea thought when I see these works of yours is, oh, wallpapers.
Yeah. They yeah, even used to print linos in squares, like a typical room, say 18 foot by 12 foot, and they would print a lino. So it came in so far from the edge of the room all the way around, and it would have a border printed onto it, and it would be printed like a Persian carpet or something like that. And that was kind of like the working man's Persian carpet, if you like, the cheaper version.
And that's more reminiscent for me also in like in palaces. They had the tiles done like that,
exactly.
That you had a border, and then in the middle you had the patterns.
I guess back to Roman times, that one.
Mosaics.
Yeah.
Lovely, thank you, Helen.
My pleasure.
Yeah, thanks, Helen.
Thank you.